Hey guys, it's Carshmallow Tech here, back with another video, and in today's video, I'm going to be unboxing and testing out the Rode VideoMicro. This microphone is made for any creator who likes shooting with either like their phones or a smaller compact camera, and they would like a smaller microphone to use while shooting, because for me, I shoot on an iPhone, which is what you're seeing this video on right now, and the audio quality isn't always so stellar with that, and when there's wind, like right now, you might occasionally hear muffled out sounds through the microphone. So that's my main reason for buying this. So let's get into the unboxing. First off, I just want to say, if you're going to plan on recording in mobile with your phone, you're going to have to also buy the SC7 TRS to TRRS patch cable in order to plug it into your phone. If you don't do that, you're going to end up getting some popping noises and things like that. So that's one thing. This is like $15 on Amazon, so it's not too bad, but it kind of stinks that it doesn't come with your microphone in the first place. But you know, so I just wanted to mention that. Also, you may want to plan on getting a mount like this that has a cold mount on top and also a place to put your phone right here so that you can actually attach the microphone above your phone. And if you don't have this, I mean, I guess you could leave it like hanging there, but obviously won't be shooting at your subject. So I'd suggest buying this, the SC7 cable, and the actual VideoMicro itself. I'll be linking all of that below in the description. So yeah, so on the box, you'll find on the front here, it just shows a picture of the microphone, and on the side, same thing. Back, it just says a couple of things, not that important. And on the side, it talks about that it has a 2-year warranty. It doesn't require batteries, it's compact size, and it's a Rycote Lear suspension mount included, which I think is how you say it, I don't know though. And there's nothing else in the box, so let's open it up. Wow, okay, I ripped the box. Okay, opening it up. So taking it out of the box here, you will find a furry windshield, and I believe the microphone's already in that, so that's nice. Take the plastic off, and right here, as you can see, is the actual microphone. Now that is pretty small. That's much smaller than I thought originally. And then here, it also comes with the mount that I was talking about. There's the mount actually attached to the microphone, and then the furry wind sleeve. So that's really how small it is. I wish I had something to compare it to, but it's really tiny. Like, that's much smaller than I thought. Here's a, I guess, a knife, so there's a comparison, but it is very small. Also inside the box here, you'll find the cable that came with it, which is a TRS cable, and this is for when you want to plug it into pretty much any camera except for your phone. So there's that, and then there's also some documentation here. It's just a quick start guide, and don't really need that either. So now let's just open up this SC7 box really quick also. Right here, you'll find another cable, and this one is the TRS to TRRS cable right here. There it is plugged in, and yeah. So let's get into some sound and test footage from this microphone.
So everything so far on this video has been shot on an iPhone 7 Plus and an iPhone 6S. But right now I'm gonna be mounting this on with my 6S because I'm shooting with the 7 Plus and that's where the audio is coming from right now. And so easily enough, you just put your iPhone into the mount or whatever else phone you're using. You screw that on and then you take the actual microphone itself and slide that onto the cold mount of this phone mount here, which is nice. Works very easily. You want to make sure with the SC7 cable that you have the black end plugged into the microphone and the gray end plugged into your phone, because that's just the only way to make it work. And then next up, you just take the gray end of the cable and plug that into your phone, and that's it. So now let's get to some audio tests. Today is actually a perfect day because it's been pretty windy recently, and so yeah, let's get into some tests. This is the Rode VideoMic sound, and this is the iPhone 7 sound. So now for the first test, I want to try directional. Like, how does the sound sound when you're turning the microphone? So right now, they're both aimed directly at me, but I'm gonna begin turning it to the side. Test, 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 test. And as you can hear, I'm pretty sure the iPhone 7 sound probably sounded a little bit better because it's not a directional microphone. The Rode microphone is directional. So if you're looking for something that's omnidirectional, you definitely do not want to get the Rode video microphone. But for me, I do want directional, so that's a good thing. So I believe it probably sounded better with the Rode. Next test is some wind. How does that sound? As you guys can see, I'm obviously outside right now, shooting outside. And so right now there's a lot of wind, so I'm gonna turn really quick. Let's see if there's any sound. There's probably some wind on the iPhone 7, but I don't think the Rode will probably have much wind, if at all any. But also about shooting outside, since I'm outside, there's lots of surrounding noises. And I also want to see how that sounds later with the Rode microphone, because with that, there's probably like little to no outside noise being picked up, which is good. That's a good thing. For my videos, that's perfect. But with the iPhone 7, there's probably lots of other noises, like maybe me walking right now. I don't know. Possibly. Maybe it's picking that up without me aiming the camera down. I don't know. But so yeah, those are two tests that I can think of. One other test that I've thought of is smaller sounds. Like if you're aiming it at like something else because you're wanting to capture a sound effect or something like that, then that is right now. So after reviewing some of the footage, I've noticed that the Rode actually sounds amazing. It sounds really good compared to the iPhone microphone because it picks up like no wind at all. I don't think I heard any wind through the Rode microphone, which is great. That's amazing because all of my videos I shoot outside, so that's kind of helpful if there's not any, you know, wind sounds, because a lot of times I'm not able to actually shoot because of the wind some days, because it's so bad sometimes, and especially being spring, it's typically really windy now. But now that I have this Rode microphone, all my videos should be great sounding and wind free. So finally, the last test that I want to do really quick is distance test. Currently, whenever I shoot my videos, I stand probably about 7 feet away from the camera. And so I want to see how distance is, because right now I'm really close up, but you know, I'm going to back up some. So let me just set this down really quick and now just back up and talk and talk. Okay, now this is really far away. This is probably like 10 feet. Let's keep going back further, further, further. You probably, I don't know how well you can hear me right now, but I'm just talking in a regular voice. So yeah. But okay, let's get closer again to the camera. Now, I'm interested to hear what that sounded like. So, the Rode Video Micro, should you get it?
Just as an editor's note, as I was going through this video and editing it, as you guys may have noticed yourselves, there was some popping and hissing noises throughout the video.
Plan on...
Well, there wasn't really a hiss, but it was like a static noise throughout the video, and I don't know why that was there, so... When I first heard that, I went to the Rode website to look for maybe there was support, maybe I was recording wrong on my iPhone, and look at what I found in big red at the top of the website. It says, important information about purchasing from Amazon in the US. Rode Microphones does not authorize Fulfilled by Amazon. We have purchased counterfeit Rode products using Fulfilled by Amazon and highly recommend that you only purchase Rode products from authorized dealers. When I went back into my Amazon purchase history, look at what I found. When I purchased this, I bought it through 17 Photo Electronics and Outdoors. Now, I don't know about you, but I have never ever heard of this seller. What the heck? Okay, I had no clue that I did this at the time of purchasing the microphone, but if I would have seen this, I definitely would have not ordered it. I thought I ordered it through either Amazon or Adorama, but that is not the case. So this is quite possibly a counterfeit microphone, which I doubt it would be, but it could be. So everything else in this video that I said about the microphone, I mean, that's still true. no matter if this is counterfeit or not, it still sounded really great compared to my iPhone. So, yeah. But I'm going to be updating that Amazon link down below to make sure that you're not buying it from a unauthorized dealer. I'm going to put a authorized link down below. So, yeah. Buy safe when buying this. I'm probably going to send it back just to make sure and buy another one from authorized. So, yeah.
First off, I just want to say I'm not sponsored by anybody to make this video. It's just my personal opinion. And in fact, I bought everything, including microphone and the cable and the mount, with my own money. So, yeah, no sponsor. But in my opinion, I would say if you're a vlogger or any other YouTuber and you use a small point and shoot, or you shoot on your phone like I do, then I would say you could definitely get by with using this. It sounds a whole lot better than your phone microphone, believe me, especially with cutting out all the like background noises and the wind. It's very, very nice. So if you're a person who uses a smaller camera or your phone to record videos, I would say this is definitely worth it. Although it's worth it for smaller camera users, I would say if you have a DSLR or a bigger camera, I would definitely suggest getting a bigger microphone. This one does not have as big of a range to record audio in as the bigger microphones do. So Rode also has some other microphones. So if you'd like to get that, I think I'll also link one of those down below in an Amazon link. So if you'd like to see that, you can see that also. But yeah, that's my opinion on the Rode Video Micro. So anyways guys, that's pretty much it for this video. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up. And if you'd like to subscribe and see more videos like this, click that button down below even if you're on mobile. If you'd like to see another video from me, you can find one up there. And if you'd like to see another random video from me, you can find that down there. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. See you in the next video. Peace.